In this video, we are going to talk about a buy stop. You don't see it here, but when you zoom into the chart, you will see that we have placed a pending order above the current market price. It will be executed when the price crosses this green line here. So let's find out how to do that with MQL5. Please click on the little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the MetaEditor window, and here we click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file SimpleBuyStop. Click on Continue, Continue and Finish. We remove everything that is above the OnTick function, and let's also delete the two command lines. First, we need to import the file Trade.mqh. This one comes with MQL5. It contains trading functions, and now we use it to create an instance of the class CTrade that will be called Trade, and we are going to use it to open our buy stop later on. To open a buy stop, we need to know the ask price that is calculated by using SymbolInfoDouble for the current symbol. The second parameter is Symbol_ask to get the ask price. According to the reference, symbol ask will give us the best buy offer. I like to use normalized double and underscore digits to get the ask price with either 5 digits or 3 digits, depending on the currency pair I use. Let's add a simple condition here. I want to check if we have no open orders and no open positions. Orders total will deliver the number of orders. An order is something you place into the market that can become a position. And positions total will deliver the number of existing positions where those orders have been executed. This one is still an order because it wasn't executed so far. But once it reaches the price that we have defined, the order will become a position. Okay, so if my conditions are true, I want to place a buy stop, and here is how we do that. We use trade.buyStop with a few parameters. The first parameter is for the lot size. The second one is for the price level. We want to buy when the price rises 200 points from the current ask price. This third parameter is for the currency pair, and underscore symbol will deliver the current currency pair on the chart. In my case, it's the Australian dollar against the Canadian dollar. This one would be for the stop loss. I did not set a stop loss here. It could be something like 100 points above the ask price. I have defined a take profit, and I would like to close the position for a profit when the price rises 400 points from the current ask price. That would be 200 points profit because the entry is executed 200 points above the ask price. The next parameter is the date when we would like to close the pending order. Order time GTC stands for good until we cancel the order. Order time day would be good until the day is over. And you could also specify a time and date. In that case, you would use the next parameter to set an expiration time. We don't do that. The last parameter would be a command. I don't use one, so I use null, all capital letters here. Actually, I could also change that. Let's say my command. Actually, we are done. So please click on the compile button. And if you don't get any errors, you can click here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, please click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. Now you should see the Strategy Tester panel, and here you want to pick the file simplebuystop.ex5. Please enable the visualization here and start a test. And this is what it should look like. Here is actually our new command, the buy stop was placed but it wasn't executed so far. It is for 10 micro lot. Here is the price that we have defined, and the take profit actually is 200 points above the entry price. And if you zoom into the chart, you will see the buy stop is here. So our little expert advisor is working. And in this little video, you have learned how to automatically place a buy stop above the current ask price. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.